Shalom, Rast Eferi, Selamt Atena Yestiling. This is Wendell Malonzo. Now, Yeshua or Jesus. Chapter 17 of the book of the Gospel of St. John, King James Version, reads. Chapter 17, verse 3 reads, "And this is life eternal, that they might know thee, the only true God, and Jesus. And Jesus Christ, whom thou hast sent." Now, in the Metzav Kedus, Kedus Johann Swengil, Me'iraf Ashra Sebat, Utir Shost, it reads, "Eunet enya, amlak bich aye honche ant ene. Yelakeshewinem Jesus Christ Osen Yawik Uzent Yehiche Yezelalim Haiwit Nat." Now, Jesus or Yeshua. It's only natural for Ayandias Rast Eferi to accept and continue in the tradition of that foundation which has been laid by Ayandai, God and Father. His Imperial Majesty, the First Power, the Trinity. There's nothing. Basically, what we're trying to present here is that there's nothing wrong with vocalizing or pronunciating the name of the Son of the Living God, our salvation, Metchanit Achan, our Savior, as Jesus. There's nothing wrong with it. Clearly, His Imperial Majesty accepted it to be. As accurate as to keep it in the book of the seven seals, and so we make mention of this because we notice kind of like a pattern in some cases we're supposing, but still it is necessary that we be careful, you know, and maybe this will kind of like do away with any potential misunderstandings or stuff concerning the name. Now, we've noticed a trend that when individuals kind of point out the name Jesus, it kind of sounds like if it's kind of said in a form in which they downplay the pronunciation Jesus, as if it's kind of like all right, but it's not really proper or it's not really accurate. Well, we beg to differ, being that His Imperial Majesty kept it in scripture. And so that to us is as accurate as it can get. Rather, this would be a matter of context. For I and I, as Rast Eferi be Amareña, Jesus is more proper. Not that it's more accurate than Yeshua, but rather be Amareña in Amharic. It is the proper way, the proper pronunciation of the Shem, the name of the Son of the Living God. And, you know, make no mistake, this is not to exalt the vocalization, the pronunciation Jesus above Yeshua. Rather, that in its proper context, Yeshua would apply to the Hebrew. You know, be amareña in amharic, Jesus is the correct way, and there's nothing wrong with it. And it's not less or it's not more than Yeshua. But I and I, as Rast Eferi, we accept it to be, we accept it, it's only natural to be that which we incline to, because it is what our language keeps, you know. And so we just felt it necessary, we know it necessary to bring this forth, because, you know, many get worked up concerning the names, and rightly so, but everything must be put in their proper context. So now Yeshua, we're not saying that it's wrong or it's far from that. It's only Yeshua applies to the Hebrew, Jesus applies to the Amharic. And so, you know, we put this message out there, we bring it forth in hopes that if certain people that post videos or do presentations and stuff like that, if ever we notice that the name Jesus is being downplayed, like, oh yeah, well, Jesus, it's okay, it's better than Jesus, it's better than Jesus, but yeah, Yeshua is kind of like if we get that tone, that kind of like downplaying of the name Jesus, and kind of like making it feel or making it seem as if it's not really all that truthful or that accurate, or just simply that Yeshua is a better way of naming, vocalizing, pronunciating the name of the Son of the Living God. You know, we bring this message forth in hopes to kind of avoid these potential misunderstandings, because it's all a matter of proper context. So we hope that this message is clear, because it is important. We kind of dozed off, but yeah, it's because honestly, like, oftentimes certain individuals, you know, they make mention of the name Jesus as if it's incorrect, and that idea is not correct. So context. Shalom Rast Eferi.